John, first of all, you've managed Hearts. People might think, what's the attraction of Derry City?
The attraction, first and foremost, to be wanted, and be wanted by a club who are ambitious, who want to do well, and have fans and a board who have the same passion for the game that I have. It's very, very important to me. You know, Derry's a big club, it's a big city. They're very, very passionate about their team in the city, and I want that to continue.
A successful season last year, two cups, narrowly missing out in the league championship. What's the aim for this year?
Well, the aim right now is to settle down and win as many games as we can. As I said to you, my ultimate aim will be to try and win every single match we start. And that's the attitude I want from the players. That's the attitude I know I'll get from the fans. And that's what we'll try and do. It may not be possible. It probably won't be possible, but that's not to say we won't be trying it. We're still in the cups. We want to win those cups if possible. We got through, fortunately, last night, but we're still there. We're in the semi-finals. And we want to try and achieve the same that was achieved last year and improve on it. As simple as that. It's going to be a tough, tough ask. You know, you come in and you've seen one of the best managers without a shadow of a doubt in the league came in at the start of the season and found it difficult because it's hard to keep those standards up, but that's what we've got to do. And if it means rebuilding, we'll rebuild. But as I say, we've got a good group of players who I'm sure will respond. And you know, it's been hard for them over the last 5 or 6 weeks, but hopefully now they can settle down, the club can settle down, and we can move forward over a sensible period of time.
Does that perhaps put added extra pressure on you, the fact that an impeccable manager came in last season with an almost perfect record but didn't do the business?
Football manager is not pressure. You know, I've got a mother back home who's got an inoperable cancer thing. You know, that's pressure. You know, you see that as that. But football's a job, and it's a very passionate job, and it's something that I really want to work hard at. And I demand the players do the same. The fans demand that. You know, I spoke to the fans at length last night after I thought it was a magnificent effort from them to get down the Cove. And, you know, if they can show that passion and that belief and that will to support the club, then surely the players can do the same on the pitch. They'll get it from myself, they'll get it from my backroom staff, and I'm sure once we settle the players down, get them fit, add one or two to the squad, then the fans will start to see they'll get exactly the same from them as well.
You mentioned potentially adding one or two players to the squad. Have you earmarked potentially any players? The 10th of July, I believe, is the cut-off date for the Champions League, and more importantly, will the board back you with regards funding?
Well, right away, you know, we've already lost two or three players due to them leaving for other clubs and injuries, etc. So there is money within the budget already there. But that's something we'll have to sit down and chat with. I'm not going to come in and wield the axe because I've got to get the strengths of the players from the existing coaching staff that's there. But we will identify the ones that we feel can be part of the squad going forward. We'll be honest and chat with ones who perhaps may not meet the standards we're looking for. And if we can bring players in, we'll do that. But as I say, we need to get one or two in before the transfer deadline. That's an important thing for European football. But we've got a long-term policy as well. As regards to domestic football. Over the years, I've seen the Aircon League improve, and you know, we're sitting in 7th, 8th place at the moment. So that tells me that the teams above us, given the quality squad we've got here, are very, very good sides. You know, they can say that Derry are underperforming, but maybe we're not. Maybe the teams above us improved. Maybe they've got better players. Maybe they've got better attitudes. Maybe they've got better fitness. As I say, that's something we'll pick up over the weeks. It's very difficult to say that after 24, 36 hours in the job. The exacting standards, but we'll pick that up sooner rather than later.